Good morning. How are you doing? It's Jim. It's Thursday. Normally I'd be doing this on a Monday, but it's not to be this week. But I'm back. It's Thursday. We're listening to John Barleycorn Must Die by Traffic. Now, I have never, ever knowingly listened to any Traffic. I know of Steve Winwood, who is in this band, but I don't know the other two. So we have in here as well Chris Wood, who's a woodwind player. He's on sax, flute, does a bit of percussion here and there. And also Jim Capaldi, who's on drums and percussion and some vocals here and there as well. I don't really know anything else about this band. Now, what I do know, well, I don't actually know, I just know of the legend of John Barleycorn is an old, very old English sort of folk song about you know, in the same spirit as traditions about the Green Man or about Wicker Man and stuff like that. But John Barleycorn is a like personification of crops and of alcohol, of beer and whiskey and stuff like that. And the song is about the life cycle of the grain and the crop and being turned into a drink and whatnot. So I think this is going to be modern, it's 50 years old, interpretation of that old song, which dates back to certainly Elizabethan times, Elizabeth I, that is, and probably older, but the first written down version of the song was that old. Now, what else do we need to know? That's all we need to know. I don't know anything else. What is it? So should we just play it? I think we should. Quite a few people have asked about this. So eventually, like everything, eventually on the channel, I do get around to listening to it. What do we have on here? We have... Let's find my glasses again. Let's see what I can do. We have got three tracks on each side. So side one, Glad, Freedom Rider, Empty Pages, and side two, Stranger to Himself, then the actual song, John Barleycorn, and then finally, Every Mother's Son. So it's a nice looking record, nice looking cover, I should say. Inside is a, if I get that the right way up, it's a portrait, but wrong way up, landscape. So it should, you know what I mean. Photo of the band. In the back we have some wood carving print, some other stuff there. Just you know, the stuff about the music. Right, I'm talking a nonsense. I am talking nonsense. Let's see what this is all about, shall we? Side one. We'll start off. So we have 6.5 minutes, 6.5-ish minutes, then nearly 5 minutes. So longish songs. Let's get on there. Oh, what's that? There we go. Right. Three. Two, one. Ooh, that's quieter than I thought it was going to be. Okay. quite bluesy. Loads on here. There are only three of them doing this, so there must be a lot of overdubbing. Good sound. I really like that little saxophone riff. That's a saxophone being played through a guitar pedal. Wah-wah pedal. That's awesome! Bit of jazz fusion, this. Certainly not traditional English folk music. No guitar. Transition into a much calmer little bit here. Of weird things. It's loving that. Mm-hmm. It's proper ear candy. This is so lovely to hear. Genuinely, wow. That was glad. This is Freedom Rider. Sort of quirky oddity compared to a lot of the music, which is all very much guitar driven, or ELP, which is obviously sort of keyboard driven. This is going in a whole other direction now. We've got this whole winds section being the driving force of the main part of the melody and stuff. This is really cool. When light amazing things about sort of progressive music is it never ever fails to deliver the unexpected. Always happy to be surprised. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. What was the final track? Empty Pages. I can't get over how good this record sounds. I mean, not the music, obviously the music, but the actual... It's not that crackly or damaged looking. This is a really, really, really good copy. Drums sound beautiful. Absolutely beautifully recorded. When everything is against me, picks me up when I'm feeling bad. So I've got something to show. Staring at the deep. That's a little bit Genesis-y. I'm not sure if that bass is being played on the keyboard with the organ or whether that is actually bass guitar. What's it say on here? Oh, you know, we have got bass guitar on here. Hey! My ears haven't let me down. Chris Wood, who's the sax player, is playing the organ on here as well. That's a cool little groove. So in the pocket, it's brilliant. Music to make you happy, it really is. Yes. surprised that there isn't any guitar. I don't know, but I thought that Steve Winwood was a guitar player. I thought that was his thing. Ooh. Oh, this record is just fabulous. Absolutely fabulous. Love it, love it, love it. Right, that's the end of side one. What a concise, compact little side of music that is. Less than 20 minutes. Perfect. Right, let's turn that off. And turn that one off. This is just so lovely. It is... there's so much of this music I need to discover and listen to. I know, it's ridiculous. And I keep saying it, and I will continue to keep saying it, because it is still as true today as it has ever been. There is more music in the world than it is humanly possible to hear. And there is more amazing music, just sort of couldn't be bettered music, that we'll never hear. And we substitute this amazing stuff for the absolute garbage that is sort of piped through our TVs and whatever, however you listen to music nowadays, of just this sort of absolutely disposable, not all of it, but a vast majority. I mean, thus it ever was, I guess, pop music. But I just can't believe that we would choose to listen as humanity to that rubbish than actually have this beautiful, amazing human art. You know, it's I know I'm preaching to the converted. I am. I'm sorry, but it saddens me. It saddens me that people don't know this exists. You know, a few more people might see this and now know this music. This is Traffic. This is John Barleycorn Must Die, the album. Apparently, this is not their first album. So they had released, maybe one or two records before this, and then split up. Steve Winwood came into the band before they split up, and then he went off to join... Ooh, what was that supergroup called? Blind Faith. He was in that. And then when that came to an end, he went back to... he put the band back together, I guess, but there was a fourth player as well who's not on this. I don't know his name, but he was a guitarist as well. So I don't know. There you go. I cannot wait. I cannot wait to hear side two of this. I'm so impressed. I'm so impressed by the sound quality. I'm impressed by the musicality, the playing, the instrumentation, the orchestration, the recording. Just everything about this is stellar. I love it. Absolutely love it. And it's another one of those records that should be on everybody's... on their radar and their consciousness. You know, I know it's not kind of sort of... I don't know. Tales from Topographic Ocean or from... Dark Side of the Moon, you know, sort of something which is embedded in the sort of the public psyche. But this kind of... is worth it. It is so worth it. And just a little bit of effort, a little bit of effort in, you get stuff out. That's what I'm saying. I'll see you guys on the next video, whenever and whatever that is. It's probably going to be side two. Spoiler! I'll see you guys on the next video. Until then, this is Jim over and...